Well, hello, hello. I hope you all are doing well out there, staying sane and taking some time to take care of yourself. My name's Amy Horniman. I am a functional medicine practitioner specializing in the thyroid, fixing people's thyroid, balancing hormones, and of course, helping with weight loss because that's something we all struggle with. So today we are going to talk briefly about what causes high reverse T3. So a brief, let's say, biology lesson so you can get a refresher on what exactly is reverse T3. Reverse T3 is the anti-thyroid hormone. So it blocks T3, the active thyroid hormone, from getting into the cell. I like to always say it's a bouncer. It's a bouncer at the door of the club, not allowing T3 to come in. The cell lets it stand there. It lets it hang out, so to speak. But when we're really looking at what reverse T3 does, it blocks T3 from getting in. So you don't have a metabolism. You're not growing your hair. You're not strengthening your nails. You don't have energy. Even though your T3 levels can look okay in the bloodstream, there's enough T3. If there's too much reverse T3, it's inactive. It's not letting the T3 into the cell. So it's the anti-thyroid hormone. And we want to talk today about what causes high reverse T3. And the reason why I'm talking about this too is because one of the things that causes high reverse T3 is stress. And right now you might be a little bit more stressed out than usual. So if you're concerned about the state of the world and your health and maybe your job, or if you got laid off and you're concerned about money, I get all that. Stress levels are a little bit higher. And what we're seeing really in the media does not help. There's a lot of fear. We don't know what's true, what's not. So our stress levels, as we're sorting through all that, are naturally going to be higher. I understand that completely. But stress is one of those things that will cause a high reverse T3. So whenever we are stressed, and I'm not talking about the immediate stressors, like a death in the family or divorce or loss of a job, although those are going on right now, especially with the job loss piece, but those are the big stressors and those will hit your cortisol, but they're more acute, they're more immediate. What we're talking about are those long-term stressors that just kind of go on beneath the surface, day in, day out, day in, day out. And even in this pandemic that we're in with the coronavirus, there is that low level stress. So while it might not be affecting you locally or immediately or with your family, you're always hearing about it, you're thinking about it, you're feeling the effects. You go to the grocery store, people are wearing masks and gloves, and that just is a constant reminder of the stress that is going on right now. So that low level stress can increase cortisol, which will then push up reverse T3. Now, with stress comes lack of sleep. And with this whole situation right now, many people are not getting deep sleep. Many people are not getting a good night's sleep and they are struggling with sleep. So if your hours of sleep have decreased, if you don't, or if you're not waking up feeling rested, that lack of sleep is absolutely going to hit you on a multitude of fronts. So the lack of sleep will increase reverse T3. And then your thyroid won't function properly, which will be a cyclical reaction of then affecting your sleep even more. And then lack of sleep also raises insulin levels. So last week on the Facebook Live, we did a big in-depth discussion about insulin resistance. I encourage you to go watch that. It was full of information, great information. A lot of people took some homework away from that they can do at home to check for insulin resistance. So high insulin is also a blocker of T4 to T3 conversion. And then if T4 cannot convert to T3, the active thyroid hormone, it will convert to reverse T3. So lack of sleep hits you on many, many different fronts. It can also cause insulin resistance, and then we get into the weight gain aspect. So lack of sleep is a big one when we're looking at what causes high reverse T3. Lack of sleep, like we said, it can actually create insulin resistance. Insulin gets in the way. Insulin will raise reverse T3 and will get in the way of T4 to T3 conversion. And then now calorie restriction. So let's talk about that. So if you're already hypothyroid and you're struggling with weight, you have an inability to lose weight, the weight's not coming off no matter what you do, your natural inclination is going to be to drop your calories, and that's not what we want to do. So if you happen to be on my webinar a couple weeks ago, it was the 5 mistakes you're doing with your thyroid right now and how to fix them. One of the things that we talked about is over dieting, restricting calories, dropping your calories too much, focusing too much on food and the amount of calories that you're taking in. Lower calorie diets not only drop free T3, so it not only drops your active thyroid hormone, but calorie restriction is seen as a stressor on the body. We just said stress, right? Stress increases cortisol. So that low calorie restricted diet will actually come back and increase reverse T3 and decrease free T3. Pretty much the last thing that you want when you're talking about weight loss and metabolism. So you're doing this in order to lose weight and it's completely working against you. You probably are actually gaining weight. And the reason why you're gaining weight is because your reverse T3 is increasing. So calorie restriction. Another one is deficiencies. So zinc and selenium deficiencies will increase reverse T3. So we know that zinc and selenium, those are both important for T4 to T3 conversion. So if we are deficient in those, and we can throw in magnesium and iodine in that as well, that will impair T4 to T3 conversion. And that T4, this goes for everyone. This goes for if you're just taking T4 medication only. This goes for total thyroidectomy, partial thyroidectomy patients, any hypothyroidism, Hashimoto's, anything whatsoever, that T4 still has to convert into T3. Even in a euthyroid patient, that T4 that's being produced by the thyroid still has to convert to T3. They don't get a free hall pass for that one just because their thyroid isn't hypo or hyper, it's very healthy, that T4 still has to convert to T3, and we need zinc, selenium, magnesium, and iodine to do so. So mineral deficiencies are another cause of high reverse T3. Leaky gut. So let's remember, 20% of the conversion of T4 to T3 occurs in the gut. 20%. So if you have gut issues and you are not addressing them, if you have underlying SIBO, H. pylori, parasites, if you're just experiencing constipation and diarrhea, that's a sign that your gut is not well. Excessive bloating after meals, heartburn. The heartburn is not normal, by the way. You should not be living on PPIs, Prilosec, and Zantac. Heartburn is a big red flag that there is something wrong with your gut and that healing needs to take place. We can do some gut healing both with food, so incorporating things like fermented foods, kimchi, sauerkraut, bone broth, kombucha, as well as eliminating some foods. So gluten, we talk a lot about gluten. So gluten is coming in and it's increasing your antibodies, but it's also breaking down your GI tract. It's breaking down your gut barrier, your protection. So with that leaky gut, those GI issues that are going on, if you do not address them and fix them, you will notice you'll have a higher reverse T3 because that T4 to T3 conversion cannot properly take place. And then that leads us right into inflammation. With leaky gut, with the excess of gluten intake and processed foods and chemicals and toxins, we see an increase in leaky gut. Leaky gut is where the gut barrier that is meant to be a completely enclosed system starts to break down and it chips away. And basically think of it as you have holes in your gut, leaky. This does not mean that you will just get diarrhea. Leaky gut does not equal diarrhea. Leaky gut can equal full body inflammation. So as those toxins, we'll just call them toxins, antigens come in and start chipping away at the gut barrier, those antigens get into the bloodstream and create an inflammatory response in the body. It's at the cell level. So it's not like you're going to see a red spot on your joint. You know, when we think of inflammation, we think, oh, I'm inflamed here. No, it's going to create a systemic response at the cell level. The cell will become inflamed. So we talked one time about doing testing for inflammation and testing for Hashimoto's. So the ESR and CRP are two tests that you can do to test for inflammation. And then last week we talked about insulin resistance. Well, insulin resistance can cause inflammation as well. And again, I encourage you to go back and watch that Facebook Live on insulin resistance and do the homework of testing your glucose, because that's how you can tell with your glucose response whether you are truly intolerant to a food or not. All of us are going to be intolerant to things like gluten and sugar. That's going to create inflammation, let's be real. But if you're taking in a food that, let's say, creates a low level of inflammation in you and it doesn't in me, something like broccoli, maybe you don't respond well to broccoli. Maybe you have an intolerance or a sensitivity to broccoli. It's still going to create inflammation in you. In me, it's going to be an anti-inflammatory agent, and you, it's going to create inflammation. So you want to test your glucose to test for that inflammation, something very easy that you can do at home. And then remember, if we're talking about inflammation, let's go back to the first couple that we talked about. Stress and lack of sleep will increase your inflammation. So you can see how this is a really nice package, right? Everything works together. Everything feeds off of each other. You got to get enough sleep. You have to eat the right food. You got to remove gluten. You got to reduce your inflammation. You have to reduce your insulin resistance. You got to check your glucose to make sure that you're not insulin resistant. Do not go on a low calorie diet and calorie restrict. That will increase your reverse T3 and decrease your free T3. Do things to heal your gut, because 20% of T4 to T3 conversion happens in the gut. And then check for mineral deficiencies, vitamin deficiencies, especially zinc, magnesium, selenium, and iodine. Those are big ones to get tested for and supplement if need be. And I'm sure we could go into so much more, but I wanted to keep this video nice and short. Think about all those things and how they all work together. That is what causes high reverse T3. This is why we need to test you. So please do not accept your doctor's answer in that we only test reverse T3 when someone is in the hospital. Now think about everything that we went over. If you land in the ER, in the ICU, of course you're going to have a high reverse T3. It's a survival mechanism of the body. It protects the body in times of trauma and stress and injury and inflammation, severe inflammation. So chances are if you land in the ER, the ICU, you're going to be inflamed one way or another, whatever is going on. And your body is going to be under stress. So yes, a high reverse T3 will be seen when you're in the hospital, but we need to check it all the time, no matter what medication you are on. If you have a thyroid problem, or even if we're trying to diagnose one, we have to check reverse T3. So those are the things that cause high reverse T3 in people. So one last thing, I want to thank you for watching. I want to remind you that if you have been thinking about working one-on-one with me, now is the time. Now's the time that you actually have the time to focus on yourself. And I'm running a ton of specials for my April patients. You'll have free lifetime access to the Complete Thyroid Fix if we work one-on-one together. And I'm also tossing in a couple other freebies. So I would love to jump on a call with you, go over your health, see how I can help you. I can go over the pricing for my services. I promise you, they're not like most functional medicine practitioners. I don't jack my prices up. I keep them very, very affordable. And with the freebies, it's just offers that you can't even pass up. So I will post my information in the description, and then that way you can reach out to me directly. You don't get a robot when you reach out to me, you get me. We talk one-on-one, and I promise you I can help you and fix you. And now's the time to focus on your health. You have the time, so let's do it. All right, thank you for watching.